Hi, I am Noriko Ogawa. I'm giving you a short lesson on Alla, Turca, famous Turkish march by Mozart. It is Kehel 331. I am playing on an upright piano from Yamaha AvantGrand, and the score appears in Pianist magazine. Now, this Turkish march is of course famous. Everybody knows this tune. Well, what is Turkish? Well, it is this rhythm. This is a typical pattern of this Turkish march rhythm. So really feel it really within yourself when you play this piece, throughout the piece. Now, when we come to the next section, this is really very important how you'd like to interpret this part. We say, oh, playing Mozart is so difficult. It is really difficult. It's one of the most difficult things to do. Why? It is because we have to decide how we would like to interpret, how we would like to articulate every phrase. So, for example, here, if you'd like to make a bit of echo, or vice versa, it is really you to decide. And Mozart didn't really specify, but you have to decide which way you'd like to do. That's why Mozart is very difficult. Well, here there is a forte piano. And this is specified by Mozart. So let's emphasize it. Now, when Mozart wrote this piece, he used a very small piano. So inevitably, your left hand cannot be overpowering. Go quite easy with your left hand, but make sure that the arpeggio is audible. Right hand full of energy. The next section. Now, Mozart is a very chromatic composer. He uses a lot of accidentals, and those semiquavers, we cannot take them just for granted. So when you practice slowly, please make some articulation, how you want to phrase it. It's like looking into each phrase with magnifying glasses. By practicing this way, when you speed up, your articulation will be just there and it flows very nicely. And also be quite loyal to fingering. It is very important that you keep your nice shape and arch when you play. Another accidental, place it and feel that it is a very special note. Now, left hand. Very chromatic movement, Again, please be aware. And by being aware, you can actually really feel it and show it in your playing. When you come back to the main theme, really play it like the first time, because this is a rondo and the same theme keeps coming back. And if you are in a different tempo, the meaning of rondo really disappears. So this is just like the beginning. And so on and so on. And then when it becomes to the comes to this forte part, now this octave now is broken. This is probably technically the most demanding part, and you cannot slow down. So when you practice, please be very close to the keyboard. If you use your hand this way too much, then you're bound to miss some notes. Be very close to the keyboard. If your hand is very small, you can still be quite close and be economical with your movement. And then we get into the coda. Now, during Mozart time, Turkey was very exotic, and their percussive instruments were very attractive to Austrian musicians. So let's emphasize those percussive effects. Those broken chords and grace notes, arpeggios in your left hand, everything should really be imitating those attractive percussive instruments. So make sure when you practice, from slowly to faster tempo. Just keep remaining very lively. I hope you enjoy Turkish March.